is a day's wait, means a wait for a day. He came into the room to shut the windows while we were still in bed, and I saw he looked ill. Now in this story, a father is narrating the story, okay? A father is narrating the story. So he came into the room, means father is telling us that his son who is 9 years old, he came into his room to shut the windows. And that time what we were doing? We were still in bed, means father and mother, they were still in bed. I saw he looked ill, and the father noticed that his boy is ill. He has got fever. So he was shivering, his face was white, and he walked slowly as though it ached to move. So the boy was trembling, shivering with fever. His face was white. White means he was looking very weak, pale because of the fever. He walked slowly as though it ached to move. Means he was not able to walk smoothly because he was feeling some pain in his body. So he was not able to walk smoothly. What matter, Chaz? Now father asked his son, whose name is Chaz. What's the matter? What's wrong with you? I have got a headache. So the boy said, I have got headache, means my head has got an ache. You better go back to bed. Now the father suggested to the son that you should go back to your room and you should, okay, take rest. Go to your room and go to bed. No, I am all right. Then the boy says, No, Papa, I just don't need anything. I am all right. You go to bed. I'll see you when I am dressed. Again, father says that, okay, you better go to the room, go to bed, take rest. I'm going to check you. Let me wear my clothes. But when I came downstairs, he was dressed, sitting by the fire, looking a very sick and miserable boy of 9 years. Now the father finally came downstairs, okay? And when father saw his son, he was dressed, means he was wearing clothes, sitting by the fire. There was a fire lighting up. He was sitting by the fire, but he was looking, means the boy was looking very ill, very sick, miserable boy of 9 years. And now we get to know his age also. So the boy is 9 years old. When I put my hand on his forehead, I knew he had a fever. So finally, when the father checked the boy, so he had got fever. So father knew that the boy has got fever. You go up to the bed, I said, you are sick. Now the father suggested, father ordered the boy that you should go to bed and take rest because you are sick, you have got fever. I am all right, he said. But the boy said, no, Papa, I'm all right. There is nothing wrong with me. When the doctor came, he took the boy's temperature. So finally, the father called for the doctor. So the doctor came and he checked his temperature. Whose temperature? Boy's temperature. What is it? I asked him. Means father asked the doctor, what was the temperature? So the doctor replied, 102. So 102 was the temperature of the boy. Downstairs, the doctor left 3 different medicines in different colors capsules with instructions for giving them. So doctor gave the medicine to the father and instructed him that these are the medicines. You have to give these medicines on time to the boy. Now the doctor goes. So there were 3 kinds of medicine. One was to bring down the fever. So what was the function of first medicine? The function of that medicine was to bring down the fever. Another purgative, means the second, the function of second medicine was टू क्लियर द स्टमक, फर्गेटिव मीन्स टू क्लियर द स्टमक. द थर्ड टू ओवरकम एन एसिडिक कंडीशन, एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ थर्ड मेडिसिन वॉज टू रिमूव द एसिडिक कंडीशन इन द स्टमक. सो द जर्म्स ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंजा कैन ओनली एग्जिस्ट इन एन एसिडिक कंडीशन, ही एक्सप्लेन. सो फाइनली द डॉक्टर एक्सप्लेन दैट जर्म्स means the influenza, the fever takes place because of the bacteria, because of the germs of acidic condition. Means when the condition is acidic in the body, so germs of influenza, bacteria of influenza, they flourish, they take place. He seemed to know all about influenza and said there was nothing to worry about if the fever did not go above 104 degrees. So the doctor said, means the doctor was very intelligent, he was learned man from his talking, right? So he says that there is nothing to be worried about, just don't worry, right, until the fever goes up to 104 degree and above, okay, but the temperature is 102, so there is nothing to be worried about. But when the fever goes above 104 degree, then you have to be worried. But now there is no worries. This was a light epidemic of flu and there was no danger if you avoided pneumonia. So doctor says that there is no danger to your boy. Okay, it is just a mild epidemic. It is just a mild flu, mild fever. Okay, but in this condition you have to save yourself from pneumonia. Pneumonia is also a kind of fever. So you must avoid pneumonia, then you will be all right. Back in the room, I wrote the boy's temperature down and made a note of the time to give the various capsules. Now what the father did? Father went back into the room. He wrote the timetable of the medicine. Okay. And he also noted down the temperature of the boy. Do you want me to read to you? Now the father asked the boy, asked Shez, that okay my son, do you want that I should read a book for you? All right, if you want to, said the boy. So the boy said, okay father, you can read a book for me if you really want to. His face was very white and there were dark areas under his eyes, because the boy was not in a good condition, right? He was pale because of the weakness, because of the fever, and he had dark areas, means dark circles all around his eyes because of weakness. He lay still in the bed and seemed very detached from what was going on. Means the boy was not taking interest in any of the things in his surroundings. He was very disappointed. I read aloud from Howard Spiley's book of pirates. Now the father started reading the book. What was the book about? Book of pirates. Pirates means the hooligans who rob the people who go on voyage. Okay, the people who go on sea voyage, right? So these pirates, they rob these people. But I could see he was not following what I was reading. So the father says that his boy, means Shez, was not getting anything. Shez was not paying any attention to what the father was reading. How do you feel, Shez? I asked him. Now the father asked Shez, okay, how do you feel, Shez? Just the same so far, he said. So the boy said, no, there is no change in the condition. And I am just feeling the way I was feeling before. I sat at the foot of the bed and read to myself while I waited for it to be time to give another capsule. So finally the father kept sitting on the bed and read to myself. Means the father started reading. Means he started reading of his own and he kept waiting for the other medicine, other capsules to give to him. So it would have been natural for him to go to sleep, but when I looked up, he was looking at the foot of the bed. Now, it is but natural for a person when he is sick, he has got fever, so he gets to sleep. It is but natural. But father noticed one strange thing. The boy was keep awakening. He was awake and he was staring. Looking me, he was staring in a very strange manner. He was staring at something. "Why don't you try to go to sleep? I'll wake you up for the medicine." So father said to the son, "So you should go to sleep. Why don't you sleep? So I'll wake you up when it is time for your next medicine. I'll wake you up. Go to sleep. I'd rather stay awake." But the boy said, "No, father, I don't feel like sleeping. I would like to awake." After a while, he said to me, "You don't have to stay in here with me, Papa, if it bothers you." So finally, the boy said to his father, "Okay, father, you don't need to bother about me. If you want to go to your room. You can just go outside. Don't disturb yourself. Don't bother yourself." "It doesn't bother me." So father says, "No, my son, you're getting me wrong. You're getting me wrong. I don't bother. Okay, I don't feel bother sitting here with you." Now, no, I mean you don't have to stay if it's going to bother you. Now the chef actually was not feeling well, so he was getting irritated. So he says, "No, I don't mean this. If you really want to go to your room, just go. Okay, don't bother yourself. Don't trouble yourself, father." I thought perhaps he was a little light-headed, and after giving him the prescribed capsules at 11 o'clock, I went out for a while. So finally, the condition of the boy, he looked quite okay to the father. So father gave him the medicine, which was to be given at 11 o'clock. After giving him the medicine, the father came out of the room. It was a bright, cold day, the ground covered with a sleet that had frozen, so that it seemed as if it all batteries. Means it was a winter season. What was the season? It was winter season, and the day was very cold. And the ground was covered with the frost, means snow. Right? So bare trees, the bushes, the cut brush, and all the grass and the bare ground had been varnished with ice. Means all these objects. What? Trees, bushes, cut brush, grass, right, ground. They all were covered with ice. I took the young Irish setter. Irish setter is a kind of dog, right? So I have, uploaded the summary also, right? Just look at the summary. You will understand Irish dog, right? Irish setter means it is a breed of a dog for a little walk up the road and along a frozen creek. So finally, father just went out along with his dog just to have a walk on the frozen path. But it was difficult to stand or walk on the glassy surface, and the red dog slipped and slithered, and I fell twice hard. Miss, it was not easy to walk on that road because the road was slippery. So the father and the dog, they just fell down many times. We flushed a covey of quail under a high clay bank with overhanging brush, and I saw two as they went out of sight over the top of the bank. It means now they were outside, and then they saw a group of birds. Covey of quail means a group of quail birds, right? So near the bank, and they just, made them fly away. Some of the covey hid in trees, but most of them scattered into brush piles. So most of the birds, they just flew away, they just hid in the trees, and most of them, they were scattered into the bushes. At the house, they said the boy had refused to let anyone come into the room. So finally, when the father came back home, the boy refused everyone to let to enter into his room. Means the boy just did not want anyone to enter into his room. You can't come in, he said. You mustn't get what I have. So boy said, please don't come into my room. Otherwise, you will be, okay, you will be caught with the same fever in which I am. Right. I went up to him and found him in exactly the position I had left him. So when father came back home and he was surprised to see the boy, because the boy was sitting in the same condition when the father left him. Right. He was sitting in the same condition, means he was staring, he was looking at the bed. But with the tops of the cheeks flushed by the fever, staring still as he had stared at the foot of the bed, means top of his cheeks, means his cheeks were red flushed because of the fever, and he kept looking at the bed. I took his temperature. What is it? Again, the father checked the temperature of the boy. So what is it? Boy asked, what is the temperature, dad? Something like 100, means it is around 100. I said it was 102 and 4 tenths. So I said to the boy, means when previously when I checked the temperature, it was 102 and now it is around 100. It means your condition is improving. It was a 102, he said. But the boy said, but the dad, the temperature was 102. Who said so? His father asked the boy. Who said so? The doctor. Father, the same thing was told to me by the doctor, because doctor said, I have got the fever of 102. Your temperature is still right. I said, it's nothing to worry about. So the father said, okay, Shell, don't worry about it. Your temperature is the same, so you need not worry. I don't worry, he said, but I can't keep from thinking. So Shell says, that I'm not thinking, I'm not bothering, right? But I can't help myself of thinking, because I keep thinking something. Don't think, I said, just take it easy. So the father said, okay, don't bother, don't think too much, just take the things lightly. I am taking it easy, he said, and looked straight ahead. He was evidently holding tight onto himself about something. So what he said? No, father, I am taking it easy, I am taking it, you know, things easy. And he just started looking straight, and the way the boy was looking at the things, it seemed that something was bothering the boy. Okay, means the boy was holding something else, means he had some, you know, some great emotions, some, you know, tough emotions, you know, running through his mind, some problem. Take this with water. So father said, okay, take this medicine with water. Do you think it will do any good? Of course it will. And the boy asked his father, okay, father, do you think that this medicine is going to help me? Father said, why? Why do you think so? Of course, you will be all right when you take this medicine. I sat down and opened the pirate book and commenced to read. But I could see he was not following, so I stopped. So again, father started reading that book for the boy. But when he noticed that boy is not taking any interest, he has no focus, so he stopped reading. About what time do you think I am going to die? He asked. So finally the boy asked his father, okay, father, please, will you please tell me when I am going to die? So father is really shocked. What? But you said. What? About how long will it be before I die? So again, the boy asked, father, please tell me when I am going to die. Means how much time is left before my death. You aren't going to die. What's the matter with you? So father said, oh, what's wrong with you? What's bothering you? You're not going to die. You're all right. What's wrong with you? Oh, yes, I am. I heard him say 102. So the boy said, "No, I am going to die, Dad, because the doctor said that I have 102 temperature." People don't die with a fever of 102. That's a silly way to talk. So finally the father said, "Okay, you're just, you know, behaving foolish. No one dies with this temperature. So it is really silly of you. You're talking nonsense." "I know they do at school in France. The boys told me you can't live with 44 degrees. I have got 102. So the boy said, "No, Dad, because I have heard in my school, some boys told me that no one can survive, nobody can live with the temperature above the temperature of 44 degree. Means people die when they have 44 degree of temperature. But I have the temperature of 102 degree. So I am going to die because I have heard it in my school from my students, from my friends. He had been waiting to die all the hours since 9 o'clock in the morning." So this is the fact. It was revealed in the story. Actually, the boy, Shez, had been waiting for his death the entire day. The whole day he was waiting for his death. "Oh, you poor Shez," I said, "poor old Shez. It's like miles and kilometers." No, now the father actually makes him understand that. "Actually, you're taking it wrong. It is like a difference between kilometers and miles. Okay, miles are different, kilometers are different. You aren't going to die. So there is nothing wrong with you and you are all right. You won't die, don't worry. That's a different thermometer. Means the thermometer with which the doctor checked you, it is something else. Means it has a separate system of measurement. On that thermometer, 37 is normal. Means on this kind, it's 98. So the father tells the boy, "Okay, in the French system, 37 is normal. But with the thermometer that the doctor checked, the 98 temperature is normal. Are you sure?" Now the boy was happy. Asked his dad, "Okay, Daddy, are you sure?" "Absolutely," I said. "It's like miles and kilometers." "Yes, my son, it is like miles and kilometers. You know, like how many kilometers we make when we do 70 miles in a car?" Okay, so he makes his son understand through an example. If we walk 70 miles, so how many kilometers we cover? "Oh," he said, "now the boys understand." But his gaze at the foot of the bed relaxed slowly. Now the boy gets to know the reality, right? Now he relaxes. So his tension is over. His tension is gone. The hold over himself relaxed too. Finally, and the next day it was very slack and he cried very easily at little things that were of no importance. So finally the next day boy started his tantrums like small children do when they fall sick. Okay, I want this, I want that. So he started his tantrum because he was relaxed now. Okay.